Are you trying to make sense of the field test mode setting for iPhone? This video serves as a guide to the two working options and covers the iPhone 6 through the 10, as well as Verizon, Sprint, AT&T, and T-Mobile. There are two primary chipsets used in the iPhone. Qualcomm chipsets are generally used for Verizon and Sprint, and Intel chipset that are primarily used for AT&T and T-Mobile. Which chipset your phone has will determine which menu you'll receive in field test mode. If you want to know the specific model that ties to the chipset that you're looking for, take a look at this table. It represents all of the newer iPhones and the actual model number, whether it's a Qualcomm or whether it's an Intel or other. Now, some of the other ones are for Japanese markets or other international locations, and they may work with Qualcomm or Intel chipsets, depending on that model. On some of the phones, the model number is printed in very fine print on the back of the phone, but if you want to determine which one you have, you can look up the model number based on the part number of your phone. To determine the part number, go into Settings, General, About, and take a look at the part number listed at the lower portion of the screen. This part number corresponds to the model number of your phone. For example, in the iPhone 8, I have model MQ722LL/A, which corresponds to the 64 gig space gray iPhone 8 from Verizon. Once you find your model number in the list and determine it is a Qualcomm or Intel chipset, then you know which menu you will receive when you go into field test mode. As I mentioned earlier, Qualcomm is generally Verizon or Sprint, and Intel is generally AT&T or T-Mobile. If you have the Qualcomm chipset, simply go into your phone, dial *3001 pound 12345 pound star, and hit dial. This will take you to the field test menu. Click on 1XEVDO. And the decibel measure number that you're looking for is RX AGC0. Now, a couple of notes about the Qualcomm chipset. It doesn't work quite as efficiently as the Intel chipset does. If you exit out of this phone mode right now, you'll actually have to restart your cell phone in order to be able to get back in and see these menu options. There's also been reports that some of the menu options don't come back with data. So I'd encourage you to do a power recycle and go in there to see if it works the very first time. For this chipset, the dBm signal strength should be in this range. Now remember, these numbers are negative numbers, so the closer you get to zero means that the larger number is a better signal. So for AGC0 measurements, anything greater than minus 70, meaning closer to zero, is an excellent signal. From minus 70 to minus 85 is a good signal. From minus 86 to minus 100, it's a fair signal. And anything less than minus 100 is a poor signal. When you get to minus 110, you'll have no signal and no service at all. For the Intel chipset, you do the same thing. Go into your phone, dial *3001 pound 12345 pound star, and hit dial. That brings you to the field test menu. This menu is quite a bit different. Click on LTE. And go to Serving Cell Measure, and the number you're looking for is RSRP0. The good news with the Intel chipset is you can go back and forth through the menus, you can exit out of the phone and come back and dial the number again, and it'll still connect to field test mode and display these numbers. The decibel signal strength works similar, but has a little bit different range. Anything greater than minus 90 is an excellent signal. Minus 90 to minus 105 is a good signal. Minus 106 to minus 120 is a fair signal. And anything less than minus 120 is a poor signal. When you reach minus 125, you'll have no signal at all. Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.